The major building blocks of cells in all organisms are proteins, which are assembled from amino acids in a sequence dictated by the genetic code. Proteins act as molecular machines that perform a wide variety of functions in the cell, including the metabolism of nutrients, generation of antibodies for protection against bacteria and viruses, and the promotion of cell growth and division. Proteins must be made in very precise amounts. When this fails or mutant proteins are produced, diseases like cancer and memory loss occur. Importantly, during virus infection, such as poliovirus, the synthesis of proteins in the cell is dramatically reduced. When I started as a PhD student in the early 70s, more than 40 years ago, we knew that protein production inside the cells involved the activation of genes that generate messages termed mRNAs via a mechanism known as transcription. mRNAs are then recruited to protein synthesis machinery, where they are decoded by a mechanism that is known as translation, that chemically links amino acids together to produce new proteins. This process is accomplished by a very large complex that contains proteins and RNA called the ribosome, which is composed of two subunits, shown in red, called the 40S and 60S. The complex reads the genetic code to add the amino acids, colored in gray, to make the protein. While the process of copying DNA and RNA was relatively well understood, and the mechanism of its control was beginning to emerge when I started my PhD work, much less was known regarding the mechanisms that control the process of protein synthesis. Most importantly, we did not know how protein synthesis begins. We also did not know why, under certain pathological conditions, such as cancer, protein synthesis increases, and whether this increase could be antagonized to hold the disease. My work, which has been dedicated to addressing this question, has uncovered the intricate regulation of translation with profound consequences for diseases such as cancer and autism and the normal process of memory formation. We identified the early steps that control protein synthesis, a mechanism that is called RNA translation initiation, and determined that their malfunction could lead to cancer. We discovered a set of proteins that direct the ribosome to the messenger RNA to commence translation. The mRNA has a beginning and an end. The mRNAs in organisms that contain a nucleus, which are called eukaryotes, possess at the beginning, on the left, a chemical structure that is called cap. In the middle, there is a coding region which defines the protein sequence. At the end of the mRNA, there is usually a sequence composed of 100 to 200 A's, adenine nucleic acid, termed poly-A. One of our first seminal discoveries was the existence of a protein that became later known as EIF4E, shown as a yellow ball, that stands for eukaryotic translation initiation factor 4E, which recognizes and binds directly to the cap structure. EIF4E is part of a complex of protein that recruits the 40S subunit, colored in red, and the other initiation factor associated with it. At the end of the messenger RNA, the poly-A tail recruits proteins colored in purple, called poly-A binding proteins, or PABPs. These proteins stimulate translation by interacting with the green protein, EIF4G, at the cap structure to bring about the circularization of the mRNA and better recruitment of the 40S ribosome. When I was 10 years old, I first learned about the devastating polio paralyzing disease. I was immensely struck by the fact that the US President Roosevelt, the most powerful man in the world at this time, was affected by it. And I wondered what renders poliovirus so extremely virulent to cause such a devastating disease. Incredibly, a major part of the answer lies in the mechanism by which poliovirus translates its mRNA into proteins. The mRNA of poliovirus does not contain a cap structure, and we were baffled like everybody else. How can it be translated without the cap structure? We were astonished by our discovery that the ribosome could bind directly to a sequence in the poliovirus, which is not at the very end of the messenger RNA, without the requirement for EA4E. This sequence is termed IRES or IRES for internal ribosome entry site. Poliovirus exploited this unique mode of translation to shut down the translation of the cellular mRNAs by cleaving EA4G and thus separating the EA4E from the rest of the complex. By doing so, poliovirus mRNA bypasses the need to compete with cellular mRNAs for the translation machinery and thus succeeds to produce large amounts of viral proteins and virus. In summary, we studied the molecular mechanism of one of the key steps by which proteins are made in the cells and discovered that aberration of this process can lead to disease.